Okay, so last class we have discussed about the active transport where I have mentioned the sodium pump and ABC transporters, etc. So today we will discuss in details about the primary active transport. So primary active transport, as like active transport, it the movement of the molecules or solute occurs from higher concentration, from lower concentration to higher concentration level against the concentration gradient. Okay, so yesterday I have mentioned the sodium potassium pump. So sodium potassium pump is the perfect example of primary active transport. Okay, so primary active transport uses ATP as a source of energy for the movement. Okay, so it moves ions across the plasma membrane, which creates a charge difference. Often a molecule enters the cell as another type of molecules leaves the cell. Often what happens, a molecules enter a cell whereas another type of molecules leaves the cell. So this creates both concentration and charge differences across the cell membrane. Okay, so this creates a concentration and charge differences across the cell membrane. Fine. Okay, so primary active transport uses ATP as a source of energy. Okay, primary active transport uses ATP as a source of energy for the movement. It moves ions across the plasma membrane, which creates a charge difference. Okay, often a molecule enters the cell as another type of molecules leaves the cell. So this creates both concentration and charge differences across the cell membrane. Okay, so the sodium potassium pump is a crucial part of many cells. Okay, the pump moves sodium out of the cell, sodium ion out of the cell, whereas the pump moves the potassium ions inside. Okay, clear? So the sodium potassium pump moves sodium out of the cell while moving potassium inside. Okay, the hydrolysis of ATP gives the cell the energy it needs during the process. So hydrolysis of ATP gives them the energy during the process. Okay, so this pump, sodium potassium pump, is called as P-type pump. Okay, there are several other types we'll mention in a letter. Okay, so this sodium potassium pump is called as P-type pump, where three sodium ions are released outside, and it brings two potassium ions inside the cell. Okay, so during the sodium potassium pump, here what happens, three sodium molecules are transported to outside while two potassium ions are transported to inside of the cell. Okay, against the concentration gradient. Fine. The sodium potassium pump binds ATP and three sodium ions. Then phosphorylation happens at the pump so that it changes its shape. This allows the sodium to leave the cell and potassium ions to be picked up. Okay, next, again, what happens? The phosphorylation reverses. Phosphorylation means breakdown of ATP to ADP plus PI. Okay, so during this process when three sodium ions are released outside, during this process phosphorylation occurs. Okay, so ATP converts to ADP plus PI. Then the two potassium ions are transported to inside. Then what happens? This phosphorylation is reversed, means ADP plus PI is converted to ATP. Okay, clear? Okay, so the sodium potassium pump binds ATP and three sodium ions, then phosphorylation happens at the pump so that it changes its shape. This allows sodium to leave the cell and the potassium ions to be picked up inside. Okay, next the phosphorylation reverses, which again changes the shape of the pump, so potassium enters the cell. Okay, this pump is important for overall nerve function and benefits of the organism. Okay, clear? So this is the mechanism of sodium potassium pump. Fine, clear? Okay, so now come to the different types of primary active transporter. Okay, there are several types. So based on the transport mechanism as well as genetic and structural homology, there are considered four classes of ATP dependent ion pumps. Okay, so just now we have studied the P class pumps, that is the sodium potassium pump, then F class pump, then the V class pump, and the ABC super family. So yesterday I have mentioned about the ABC transporter system. ABC means what? ABC means ATP binding cation. Okay, so this P type ATPase or P class pump, such as the sodium potassium pump, they exist in eukaryotes, bacteria and archaea. Okay, so P type pumps are present in the eukaryotes, bacteria and archaea, whereas F type ATPase or F class pump exist in mitochondria, chloroplast and bacteria. V class pump or the V type ATPase exist in eukaryotes, and the ABC transporter or ABC superfamily exist in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Okay, clear? So P class pump, they exist in the eukaryotes, bacteria and archaea. F class pump exists in mitochondria, chloroplast and bacteria, and the V class pump exists in eukaryotes, and the ABC superfamily, they are present both in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Okay, so I have given the sodium potassium pump cycle in a pointwise manner, and the diagram is also required for the examination purpose of view. So just go through that, and whatever I have discussed now, it's all the same. Okay, fine.